Hello friends, it's great to see you back. Today, we will learn how to create a custom shape and size for a structural member in AutoCAD Plant 3D. Let's start. First, navigate to the C drive and locate the AutoCAD Plant 3D content folder. Next, open the CPAC common folder and find the structural catalog.acat file. Open this file using SQLite Expert Personal. You can find the freeware software download link in the description. In the structural catalog hierarchy, select PNP Base. Switch to the Data tab on the right side. Scroll down to the bottom of the rows to check the last used PNP ID and row ID. In the Data tab, look for the PNP class name. Type shape data under PNP class. Name to filter for shape data rows. Choose any row, right click, and select clone record from the context menu. Be careful not to click elsewhere on the table to avoid pop-up errors. Just keep clicking OK to dismiss them if any error pops up. Another way to avoid multiple error pop, insert new record by clicking on plus icon and copy all the values from relevant row to new row. Next, right click on the PNP ID cell and choose text editor from the context menu. Enter the next available number. For instance, if the last PNP ID was 5696, you would enter 5697. Click OK, and the row ID will be filled in automatically. Now, head over to the free online GUID generator website. Link is in the description. Make sure to check the options for hyphens and braces, leaving the rest unchanged. Simply click on Generate some GUIDs. Copy the generated GUID and paste it into the newly created PNP GUID cell, replacing the old values. Next, select shape data in the structural catalog hierarchy. Again, scroll down to find the last used PNP ID and row ID. Select the shape for which you want to add new sizes. In this example, we will use the C3x6 channel size rows to create a new C3x7 channel size rows in the database. Right click on the C3x6 row and choose clone record from the context menu. Remember to avoid clicking elsewhere to prevent pop-up errors. Just keep clicking OK to dismiss them if any error pops up. Another way to avoid multiple error pop-ups, insert new record by clicking on plus icon and copy all the values from relevant row to new row. Finally, right-click on the PNP ID cell again and select text editor. Enter the next available number for use. For example, if the last number used in PNP ID was 5696, you should input 5697. Then, click OK. The row ID will be filled in automatically. Next, navigate to the free online GUID generator website. The link is provided in the description. Ensure that the format includes hyphens and braces while leaving the rest unchanged. Simply click on Generate some GUIDs. Once generated, copy the GUID and paste it into the newly created size record ID column cell, replacing any old values. After that, update the shape size description to C3x7. Adjust the shape height to 3 and the shape width to 1.7, which are the dimensions for a C-type channel. Feel free to modify these dimensions as needed. Since we have duplicated the C3x6 channel size rows, the content geometry parameter definition values will automatically transfer from the C3x6 channel size. If desired, you can alter the geometry dimensions to suit your requirements. In the structural catalog hierarchy, select Steel Structure. Then switch to the Data tab on the right side. Choose any row, right-click on it, and select Clone Record from the context menu. Finally, right-click on the P&ID cell and choose Text Editor from the context menu. Input the same number used in P&P base, for example, 5697 in this instance. Click OK. The row ID will be generated automatically. Begin by right-clicking on the structural catalog in the left hierarchy. From the context menu, choose the option to close all databases. If AutoCAD Plant 3D is currently open, restart the application. Next, create a new drawing file within the Plant 3D models. Switch over to the Structure tab. From the drop-down menu, select the Shape model to display solid members. Now click on Settings in the Member Settings dialog box. Choose the C shape, scroll down to the bottom, and you will find the new C3x7 channel size added to the catalog. This method allows you to add new sizes to any existing shape or modify the shapes and sizes of the structures already available. Please note that the language used in the content geometry parameter definition is German. Utilize Google Translate to comprehend the meanings and input the values accordingly. And that's all. You have successfully incorporated a custom structure member shape and size in AutoCAD Plant 3D. If you found this information useful, please like, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell icon. Thank you for watching and see you next time.